Hello guys, it's Ryan Ho back with another video. Today I want to talk about the Er3XR XR. So the XR stands for extended response. What that really means is that it has much more bass than its normal models. So I reviewed previously the Er2 SE and I just found it just to be a little bit bass light. And it didn't have much like impact or feeling to the bass. And trying the Er3 XR, this definitely has a lot more bass, but the bass isn't like bloated or anything like that. But anyways, before we start this review, please like and subscribe down below. It really helps my videos out. I'm trying to hit that 1,000 subscriber mark to get to become like an official quote-unquote YouTuber, right? So it would be much appreciated. And yeah, so first thing, let's talk about the build quality. The fit and the comfort is kind of a long tube. So as you can see, it has to kind of go in really deep into your ear. So I find it sometimes it just moves a little bit too much because a lot of other IEMs kind of the shape contours to your ear, while these are kind of just this long and skinny tube. So if you don't stick it like far enough into your ear, it'll kind of move a little bit and cause the fit to be a little loose sometimes. And then when it comes to just like the build quality of this, the tip is just a normal silicone, nothing special. This is actually made of metal, it's pretty sturdy. And then it just has a pretty standard wire, nothing too special. But, you know, it terminates into a 3.5 millimeter. So yeah, that's about it. All right, so let's talk about the sound quality. How does the Er3 XR sound? So like I mentioned earlier, this is the more bassy edition, and it's not like the bass is like bloated at all. It's just a little bit above neutral, and it gives the bass a lot more feeling, a lot more impact, and it really rounds out the sound. It makes it a lot more exciting than the other counterpart. And I really find the bass to be very clean. Like, it's fast and it's like impactful, but it's just clean. It's very crystal clean, especially compared to some of the IEMs I have up here. Like, this bass is just very muddy. This one has a lot of bass. This is like, I'll eventually review this one, but yeah, this is one of the cleanest basses I've heard. And yeah, now continuing on to the mids, and like the overall resolution of this Er3 is very, very clean. Like, honestly, this might be one of the most resolving IEMs I've ever heard. And that says a lot, like, especially for a price point of $100. This thing is very, very resolving. I think it out-resolves basically everything on this table, and that is saying something. It is very clear through the mid, so male vocals, female vocals. When we get to the treble, that's where these earphones get a little bit darker than normal, so I feel like they could do just a little bit more extension than the treble, because I feel like the treble response is actually pretty good. It's still better than a lot of things. But if I want to be like absolutely most critical about this, I would say the treble could be a little bit more extended and get a little bit more air quality, because I feel like this treble response is kind of just pushed down a little bit, and it causes us a little bit of this like congestion feeling, a lack of air. And something like their you know, Er2 SE really did the treble response a little better in my opinion. And I felt like this treble was really, really good and like essentially perfect almost, versus this one just needs just a little bit more extension. But besides that, I feel like this, even if I compare these two models, I still think I would prefer the Er3 because this one just has much more bass and that really rounds out the music for me. And I feel like that's ultimately what makes it much more effective for modern genres and most things that people want to listen to. And I think that's what makes this one superior. And compared to, you know, a lot of other IEMs, I think this bass brings it up to much more of a competitive level as well. These things are quite amazing. Even though they like look like these little skinny little things, like they don't look as like fancy as other ones you see in the market, but when it comes to sound, these really do bring great detail. Like, it's quite amazing, especially for, like I said, the price of $100. You can probably find it cheaper on certain websites as well. And yeah, this makes it one of the best values in my opinion. So let's go over some comparisons. So I basically already compared this to the Er2 SE through the whole review, but basically this is the bassier version that has a little bit of a darker treble. But yeah, I still prefer this over the Er2 SEs. However, if I compare this to like the Moondrop Aria, which is about the same price point, around the $100 price point, and I would say the Aria has a lot more quantity of bass than the ER3s. And I think it will come off a bit more fun in the Arias and more engaging. So if you like more bass, I think I would go with the Arias. But I do think the XR has overall, like across the spectrum, has a little bit better resolution and it's a little bit tighter in general. So it has a little bit more clarity in general. But through the mids, I think they're pretty competitive with each other, about the same. And then when you move to the treble, that's where it gets like kind of interesting to me, because I feel like the XRs are a little darker, and while the Arias are a little bit more balanced in the treble response, but then I think the XRs are just a lot more resolving in that area, to the point where it's like you can't hear like the same micro details as you can hear on the ER3s. I feel like they just have a little bit more detail in that area. And overall, I think if you're going for a little bit more like balanced tuning, I feel like the ER3s would be a little bit more neutral, versus I think the Arias a little bit more bassy and more engaging and fun. If you're looking for that character, I would go for the Arias. And of course, their fit is something that's also different. I feel like the Arias fit a lot better. They don't really move around, versus I know these tips just, they kind of move around for me a little bit, so a little harder to like get inside your ear, but you know. So for me, I would prefer the fit of the Arias as well. So in conclusion, do I recommend these? Obviously, it's a yes. These, as I said earlier, do everything right, basically. If I want to be the most critical thing, what you can expect from something maybe more expensive. I haven't tried their ER4, but maybe that fixes kind of the treble response issues I have with this. And maybe that would be like the perfect like version of these Etymonic ones, because besides that one little area of refinement, I think this thing is very, very good, and honestly anyone would be happy to listen to this. Thank you guys for watching. Please like and subscribe down below. It really helps my videos out, and I'll make obviously more IEM videos eventually. Obviously I'm gonna still do headphone videos as well, but I have a few of these IEMs that I get through. So yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.